Okay, hi. We're in our hotel bathroom. It's good lighting and
Q&A time.
But we're also gonna wash our faces and get ready for bed at the same time.
So first, thank you to everyone who sent in your questions today. We couldn't get them all in this video because there were just so many.
Wash your faces.
Let's do as many as we can. Okay.
I'm getting ugly.
Alright. So the first question comes from our good old friend, Lila. She asked us.
Lighting's really good here.
Ready? She asked us, why are you such a noob? Question mark. Jackie, would you like to answer that one?
Because Anna is herself. If you didn't know, there's a code in her name, and if you undo the code, it spells out noob.
Yep.
If you go on your computer and go, and then it goes that. So,
yep.
If you didn't know, there's a fun fact for the day.
Okay, this comes from Lily.
Is the whole road trip gonna be extremely extra? But
I'm gonna go with yes, because if you put me and Jackie in the same location with a bunch of cameras and a YouTube channel,
you literally have like four cameras, including our phones.
Yeah, like, and I almost brought my camera as well. Okay, the next one is from our good friend Megan. Megan asks, did you really just send us your numbers?
Yes.
I think it's self-explanatory.
It's the total answer.
It wasn't me, it was her. Okay, number four. Also from Megan, can we have a picnic? We're a little preoccupied right now.
A little busy, but
come back. If,
yeah, sure.
You
know.
I mean, I don't know what that had to do with this or anything.
Will it
but
be gluten-free?
Vegetarian.
If yes, sure. Okay, next question. Then we got a lot of good ones from our good old friend Holt. So the first question he asked is, what do you guys look for in guys?
Super cliche. Basically, some arms, some legs, a torso, stable head, and anatomy, like just like body structure is important. But again,
what about personality wise? I like someone who's a feminist. I like someone who hates women.
Misogynistic and really wonderful.
They need to hate women. They have to hate women.
That is the main thing you're looking for.
They also have to be polygamists.
If you would have any superpower, what would it be? Probably to be a psychic so I can ruin people's lives. Telekinesis so I can fuck with people.
You need points.
They kind of hit it.
Alright, well, my superpower would be like I could turn any food that I saw into a gluten-free food.
Okay, Anna, you know that there's this movie with the Lucas Gabriel and it's like Food Boy or something? And one of the episodes he's in a like school bathroom and he just like his eyes like produce food. So he just like gets like drowned in pieces of loaves
of
bread.
Where do I meet him? Because that would be my true love.
He gets like it's a Disney movie. He gets like drowned in like loaves of bread because he can't stop thinking about bread.
Next one from Fave book question.
Definitely, what's that book called?
My favorite book is this book I got when I was younger. It's a guide to every fairy in the world, and it tells you all about them.
Was that the interactive one where you can like, get the glitter?
And, you can get glitter and stuff, and you
I found it. Okay, my favorite book, Holder, I heard a little beef about you. My favorite book is Buckland's Guide to Witchcraft, Buckland's Book of Witchcraft.
Yep.
I know you think it's like fake, but listen to this hat. It's a religion, it's pagan, Google it. It takes like simple Googling.
Alright, the next one is from, I hate her. Her name's Jackie, and she asked me a question directly. It is, how many fingers and toes do you want your significant other to have? If they're missing any, would you mind, or would that be a turn off? A preferable number for like hands and like the fingers and toes combined would be like in like the 30s, maybe like 28, around there. Any less is like really not committed enough. And if they had any less, no, it would not be a turn off because I cannot handle that. If they were missing one of the 30s, I mean, it's my opinion.
Basically, it reads, it's from this, I don't know where that
I heard she's a bitch.
involved in a human sacrifice ritual on July 8th, 2017. Be there. I'll be one of the sacrifice people, and it's going to be a blast.
Our last question of the night comes from Samuel, and he says, it's a very long one, so sorry. It is, you're on an island in the middle of nowhere. No one is coming to save you. Also, on this island is Dwayne Rock Johnson, who's actively trying to hunt you down and kill you. What three things do you bring to ensure your survival? Guns, powerful weapons, and off the limits. Which I can go first? Alright, so I can bring three things to this island and I can protect myself from Dwayne Rock Johnson. But here, my theory is, it's not about survival, it's about surviving. So, what I would do is I would get
myself... Sounds like a TLC. Sure, surviving you do.
I would get to myself before he could, so I won. So pretty much I'd probably say like a honey badger. Because they're very like hostile animals that could protect me. So yeah, honey badger. And there's two more, but like I'm not gonna say them. What's your answer, Jackie?
I don't have an answer to this question.
Okay, well, that's the end to all our questions. Thanks for watching. We will see y'all. We'll see y'all tomorrow. This will hopefully be up soon. I'll send out the link. I'll post it on my Facer, Twitter, Snapper,
you don't have
Tumblr,
a Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, anything, and you just have a Facebook and Snapchat.
But yeah, we will see y'all tomorrow. Thanks for watching.
You have to make it like dark. like what?
Oh, Jesus. Did I stop the recording?